the Million Mask Mayday, which is a national movement.
So you're sewing these masks at home. What has that been like?
Insane. It's a lot of work, and I am disabled, so it's painful for me, but
wow,
taking it slowly and doing what I can. It actually came down to the fact that I was cutting out the materials to be sewn by somebody else because sitting in front of the sewing machine was getting to be too much.
Yeah, that's monotonous and hard on anyone, an able-bodied
yeah.
person. That would be difficult. That's why I wanted to reach out, because we have this massive audience, and I wanted to kind of alleviate some of this. You're doing something so incredible, and it's the least I could do to give you a call and share this message. So why did you decide to do this?
Because I have friends in the healthcare industry, and as a parent of a special needs kid, I really, really need this pandemic to stop as soon as possible so that my child doesn't get sick. He is legally blind, has cerebral palsy, epilepsy, and his seizures have been off the wall since we've been quarantined.
Wow.
So if we have an emergency, we're kind of screwed. And I want my friends to be safe. It's definitely hard being trapped in the house. And
yeah.
Like, if we have an emergency, we can't just go to the hospital. We can't
right.
do anything like that. So we really need to do whatever we can to help those on the front lines get this, you know, nipped in the bud so that we can go back to normal life.
I can hear it in your voice how emotional this has been, and I know so many people can relate to that. You're doing this insane, incredible service, even though it's not just like something that you're doing breezy breezy with your free time, you know, with your
yeah.
partner working. It's like all good. Like, no, this is a major burden, but you're taking it on and amid everything else going on in your life. I find that absolutely fascinating and so inspiring. How many masks have you been able to produce since you started doing this?
I personally have made 30 or 40 masks. I have a friend down the road that dropped off 48 masks to me, and we've delivered those masks out. I cut out material for another probably 60 masks and gave that material, had her pick that up from my porch. She's making those. We have probably 100 people in just the Northern Colorado group doing this. One of my friends in the healthcare industry that originally asked for masks, she has picked up from my porch. Yesterday, I dropped off some to a location in Fort Collins because I had to go get prescriptions.
Yeah.
So I was already out, and I had the bag in my car and kind of just tossed it out my window.
Dude.
To them that came out of the ER to grab that. So
I just can't believe that amid all of this emotional, personal stress that you're under, like even like on a daily basis, but even more so now, like you're one of the people whose families is affected in a very, very significant way, and you're still doing all of this. That is incredible. I just want to get as many people all hands on deck as I can. So what's the process? Do you have a pattern? Where are materials coming from? How can people help?
If you do a Facebook search for Million Mask Mayday - Colorado or Northern Colorado, we've got two groups. I'm up in Loveland, so I work in this area. The other Colorado group works mainly in Denver. We have links to the mask patterns that are the easiest ones to do and the ones that hold up the best under sterilization. All of these hospitals and nurses and stuff that get these masks, they have to bleach them, have to put them in the hottest water possible to make sure that they're not getting sick if somebody is making a mask that has no symptoms but they're sick.
I didn't even think of that.
That's something that has to be taken into account. We have to make these stand up. And these masks, they're not being worn just by themselves. These masks are to be worn over the N95 masks to help them last longer. A lot of the masks that we're making have pockets where you can insert another filter.
Oh.
So that will help filter out any more of the sickness before it reaches the N95 mask, so that these masks can be reused and washed and the filters can just be thrown away. And that will hopefully make the single N95 mask that these nurses are having to use over and over and over again last longer.
Yeah, because they're only supposed to use them for like an hour as soon as they get wet.
Yep, we have it set up in the group that there are special topic tags. You can click on tutorial and it'll take you to the post with a link to the mask videos, the do-it-yourself.
Kai, thank you so much for not only talking to me, but for doing this. I am very inspired by you and I appreciate you so much.